bottoms when life started taking its toll. Saturday's Pete and I'd call up each other. We'd pack up the dogs and we'd go. Crammed in a 69 Scott International, even the streets and the noise. We must have looked like a traveling kennel with Clancy and the boy. Clancy was Pete's favorite red iris setter. He'd had him for 10 years or more. After we finally pulled up to the riverbank, Clancy was first out the door, followed by two Irish wolfhounds and my little spitz dog named Peter and me. After us all being penned up and cooped up, well darned if we didn't feel free. For Clancy and the boys. Pete and I'd watch while the dogs chase each other. We'd laugh as they rolled in the sand. And after a while, well, I'd unload some problem on Pete and he'd understand. And after we'd gone over all the world's problems and solved everyone but our own, we'd call the dogs and pull things together and start loading up to head home. Hey, run, Clancy, run. Come on, boy, we don't want to leave ya. Well, sometimes I still hear them voices of Clancy and the boys. Years have gone by now and Pete's out in Denver. Lord, I hate to see him that far. And me, I'm in Nashville just trying to write what can only be said with a heart. Clancy and all of the rest have gone on to wherever good, faithful dogs go. And I've lived with dreams of a magical brotherhood still alive deep in my soul. Hey, run, Clancy, run. Sometimes in my dreams I still see ya. I wake up still hearing the voices of Clancy and the boys. Run, Clancy, run. You've waited so long for your freedom. Now somewhere the river rejoices for Clancy and the boys. Somewhere the river rejoices. Somewhere the somewhere the river rejoices for Clancy and the boys.